People occasionally ask me how I, a British man, came to live in Germany. So in this video, I'm going to answer exactly that question. I mean, of course I am. What did you expect when you clicked on the thumbnail? Obviously, the best place to start any story is the beginning. So here goes. I was born in 1970 and grew up in a town called Glastonbury, which is famous for being a particularly weird place. Studies, and at that point, I decided that I was going to study modern languages, and I got a place at the University of Wolverhampton. But before I started the course, I took a year off and spent it in Germany, working as a volunteer in a nursing home and living in Herrenberg. The result of that, of course, was that when I went back to England, I had to get out of the habit of speaking German with a Swabian accent. So I started my course. I had to pick two languages to study, so I chose German, which by now I was very good at, and Russian, which I started from scratch, or as they call it in university circles, ab initio. It was a four-year course. The third year was spent studying at foreign universities, one semester in Berlin and one semester in St. Petersburg. I graduated in 1993, which is before half of you watching this were even born, which makes me feel incredibly old. But anyway, here was my problem. I was at this point practically fluent in German, but my Russian was still very basic. So how was I going to fix that? Easy. Spend a year living in Russia. It was an excellent plan. In those days, I could have walked up to just about any university, knocked on the door and said, "I am a native English speaker and I am available to teach." And they would have said, "When can you start?" It was an exciting time to be alive. The Iron Curtain had only just gone, and Russia was beginning to open itself up to the Western world. This meant there was suddenly a huge demand for English, and not enough people to teach it. However, the country was in a bad state. With the old regime gone, the political atmosphere was, not to put too fine a point on it, chaotic and unstable. Yeltsin had just saved Gorbachev from a coup, only to then stage a coup of his own. And after decades of Soviet rule, Russia's economy was in a mess and the country was falling apart. Quite literally. I remember being on Nevsky Prospekt, which is St. Petersburg's main boulevard, and seeing all the trolley buses at a standstill because one of the beautiful cast iron lampposts had rusted all the way through, fallen down, and taken the overhead power lines with it. Criminal gangs were fighting to fill the political vacuum, and nasty diseases like cholera were spreading as the infrastructure continued to crumble. And so, to cut a long story short, my parents vetoed my decision. Now, I'll be honest, this is the only time I can ever remember my parents telling me not to do something that I had planned to do. Usually, their philosophy was that I was free to make whatever stupid decisions I wanted to make, just so long as I was prepared to accept the consequences. But this was different. So I listened, and boy am I glad I did. I ditched my plans to spend a year in St. Petersburg and decided on a compromise. I would go halfway. I would go to Berlin. My plan was actually to spend maybe 6 months or a year there before returning to the UK to find a job. But every time I thought it was about time I thought about returning home, some opportunity would suddenly appear that it would be foolish of me to miss. Unfortunately, every time that happened, the opportunity went nowhere. And so the cycle continued until I'd lost touch with all my friends in Britain, and now all of my friends were in Germany. And after about 10 years of just about hanging on in Berlin, I met a young lady who, as it turned out, lived in a tiny little village in the extreme northwest corner of Bavaria. And here I still am. And that is the story of how I got here. Weird place, at which point I'm going to start talking meaningless drivel. The point is that what I'm going to do here is to just jibber jabber meaninglessly on and don't care about any particular slip-ups or fluffs or whatever, because I'm just going to speed it up and make